So today I'm going to talk about how to get recruited and why I cut my hair.
El Morado, native to my land like Navajo. The chief is doing everything he can for the corn coast. Nothing that I built has gotten foreclosed. A god amongst immortals, God is here from wormholes. They say the imitation is the purest form of flattery. So when I see you doing what I did, can't be mad at me. Sign and seal delivered, yours truly, Mr. Drifter. They won't recognize you great until they miss you, huh?
Why are my basketballs rolling down the street? What are you doing?
The reason I cut my hair is because my hairline was getting very bad. It was way worse than last year. Like, I didn't even realize for the longest time until like the last month. I was like, dang, it's kind of getting. And I always told myself, I was like, I'm not going to be that dude hanging on for dear life. When the shit starts doing the fucking Vegeta or the cul-de-sac, I'm not going to be that guy. So I was like, whenever that time comes, I'm just going to cut. So it was that time. And I didn't feel like getting like a derma roller and all this ointment and all those oils and stuff. I didn't want to do all that because that stuff takes like 7 months anyway. So maybe when I'm rich, I'll get the Tory Lanez and make a comeback. But yeah, that's what it is. But to get to the recruiting part, like this is what I would do today, all right? Because I didn't get recruited when I was in high school, mainly because I got hurt my senior year, and then that made me not start. I missed the first game of the season. And then I didn't start. And then I kind of started halfway through the year. And then I stopped starting. And I wore a knee brace the whole time. And then I got surgery like as soon as the season was over. So that's kind of how that went. But this is what I would do today. Like, this is would be my full strategy if I was like, okay, I really want to get recruited. I'm not getting any looks. This is what I would do. Okay, number one, I would make sure I go to a high school that is gonna let me play, like get minutes. You know what I'm saying? Not just like be the man, but like get on the floor. That's the number one thing. If you're not on the floor, there's almost nothing that can. And later on in the video, I'll talk about if you don't get minutes, what to do. But this will be my full strategy. Number one, get minutes. Okay, ask your coach how to get minutes. If he's not down with it, transfer. Literally. Okay. Because that's what I should have did when I was a sophomore in high school, because I kind of knew what was coming. So I should have went to Southwest, which was my plan, but didn't do it. So I would do that. And then what I would do is I would make every social media available. I would make a YouTube. I would make a Huddle account. I would make a LinkedIn account. I would make a Twitter account. I would make a... Did I say Instagram? Instagram account. I'd make every account possible, and then I would make myself look good, like as far as like structure wise. So I would say my name. I'd put my stats, kind of like a the same way you look at a player bio. Like if you go to ESPN, you type in freaking Kyrie Irving, says born here, or whatever. Says what team he plays on. Says his height, his weight, all that good stuff. I wouldn't be looking all sketchy. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm being dead serious. So I would do that, clean up your profile, make it look good. And then I would film all of my workouts. I would get film of every single game, even if you're on JV or freshman or reserve. I would try to get film of every game. So, like, tell your mom, hey, can you film these? Or your cousin or your brother or something. Get film. Like, I literally have one film of me playing high school basketball. I think basketball, period. I don't have any film. That's strange. I didn't think of that back then. But I would get as much film as possible, whether that be practice, game, workout, anything. I would film it all. And then I would put it everywhere. You know, so I would put it like... I'd put game film, like full game, and then I would put highlights of the game film. And so, because coaches want to see a full game, you know, they want to see that on top of highlights. So, like, highlights, yes, that's what you're going to do naturally. But get film, like full games. I'd put that on YouTube. I'd put highlights on LinkedIn. I would put stats. I'd put my workouts on LinkedIn. I would put my workouts on Twitter and everything and all that. And then what I would do as well, once you get that established, like you're a content creator now, like you film everything that you do basketball related. Like you don't have to film yourself freaking stretching and like lifting weights and all that dumb stuff. Like just like basketball skill stuff, okay? And then I would follow every like person that's associated with basketball, period. And like interact in their comments and all that stuff. Cause like the people that follow me, they might not know, like I look and see, like there's people in other countries that I look at and I'm like, dang, they're a good player and they're only like 15 years old. And so like, if I was a college coach, I'd be keeping my eye on them for a long time. They don't even know that I'm watching. And so you never know who's watching, honestly. Like I might become a college coach one day, and if you follow me and I some randomly look at your profile and you got film, I might say, hey, are you getting recruited? You know what I'm saying? You just don't know. So I'll follow a bunch of people that are associated with basketball. And then I don't think you can get recruited until you're a junior. I don't really know the rules around that. I got to do my research again. But I'll just keep putting out content, follow people that matter. And then what else I would do? Let me think.
So once you get that established, right, then I would map out every single college that you want to go to. So like, and you also have to know your skills. So like, if you're not ready for D1, don't be trying to go hit up every single D1 coach, but you got to be honest with yourself. And if you don't really know, then you have to find people. I'm watching some craziness on, I'm watching soccer and they're showing some craziness at halftime. I don't know what's happening. But I would show, what was I saying? Shit. I forgot because that distracted me. So I would get honest feedback, like measure yourself against like players and think to yourself, are you really as good as, you know, so-and-so that's getting recruited by D1 or D2, like you gotta really know. And then I would reach out to them and just be like, hey, what would I say? I would say, hey, I'm really interested in playing college basketball. What can I do to be ready and to get myself to that level? Like I wouldn't ask them like, hey, recruit me. Like that's the worst way to go about it. So like you can ask like, hey, what do you look for in your recruits? Or what is a good way to get to college and play basketball? Or like, how do I find tryouts? Like ask questions that they would help you with, but that's not directly related to them. And so it'd be the same if I asked somebody for a referral, I'd be like, hey, do you know anybody that's good at making videos? I wouldn't ask them, hey, can you make me videos? You know what I mean? Or like if I'm trying to sell a service, hey, do you know anyone that would need marketing services? And they'll be like, oh yeah, I know this one guy. Don't ask them, hey, do you need marketing services? They're gonna be like, no. Even if they do, they're gonna say no. And so just ask questions that are like, that they can kind of help you with, that seem like, that doesn't seem like you're trying to go to their school and like try to get them to like bring you on, stuff like that. Because the best school to go to is the school that wants you, not the school you want to go to. So that's a little gem for you. So that's what I'll do. I'll do that for D1, D2, D3, NAIA D1, NAIA D2, JUCO. You know what I mean? I'll just map out 10 each, probably, and just kind of see where it goes. And then what I would do is, okay, now for this part, this is for people who don't have any film or like who don't get a lot of minutes and college coaches aren't seeing them play. I would map out 30 JUCOs, 30 D3s, 30 NAIAs, so that's 90 schools that you think you might want to go to, and then email the people. Like, it doesn't even have to be the head coach. Like, I would look for the assistant coach because they probably got more time on their hands. Like, head coach ain't trying to answer emails from some rando. But, like, if you get, like, the volunteer assistant, be like, hey, I'm trying to try out. Do you guys have tryouts where people can come? That's how I got to college. Like, I tried out. I had no choice. my knee is messed up. I wasn't getting minutes. So I tried out for the college I went to. But that's the hardest route because they don't really want you. You kind of just showed up. And so they're not going to prioritize you. So know that going in. Know that it's going to be a grind. But if you do it the right way, it'll work out for you, you know? And so I would map all those schools out, get like 90 schools at least, and I would email people that are associated with it or hit them up on Twitter or hit them up on Instagram or LinkedIn. This is where your content comes into play. So if you've been filming your workouts, if you've been filming your games, filming scrimmages, whatever you have to show, and you hit these people up, the first thing they do is look at your profile and they're like, oh, okay, he looks like he can do this. He's, you know what I mean? Hey, let's bring him on for a tryout. And so instead of it's just some blank profile, some kid, and you got one picture on your Instagram, and they're like, who is this? Dang, they just scored a goal. They called it offsides? I missed it. But that's what I would do. And then I would go to those tryouts and try out. And then on top of that, while you're at the tryout, get someone to film those, because then you have scrimmage tape. And so it's something. It's better than nothing. And so that's what I would do. And like, I don't see how that would fail for getting you to college. I really don't. So I think that's all the strategy I got for that. If I forgot anything, I'll make a part two of this, but that's like, that would be my plan, dude. And like, the best route to go is JUCO. If you have absolutely nowhere to go, JUCO is the best route to go, because you can go from JUCO to D1, you can go from JUCO to D2. No matter where you are, you can go from JUCO to that level. And so, and while you're there, JUCO's tough. And while you're in JUCO, you get to practice with D1 level players. You get to play against D1 level players from other JUCOs, and that kind of tests yourself. But if you go straight to NAI, if you go straight to D3, you're only playing D3 competition. You're only playing NAI competition. And so you don't really know where you stack up. Could you transfer higher? Could you do this? You don't know. And so whatever D3 or D2 or D1 you end up at, you'll go there regardless after JUCO. So you might as well go to the JUCO. The school's easier anyway. It's less money. And that's what I'll do, man. Yeah, but try your best to not get in debt. That's what I'm going to leave you with. So that's it. Hope that helps.
Little 2 minute jump, right? Rest in peace, Guru. It's cold as shit in this booth. How finna?